Yeah, I mean, I'm really, obviously, I'm happy with the win. You know, we talked all week about, you know, really trying to do a good job with home games and defending our field, and there's added importance when it's a home game and it's an Ivy League game, and then it's really even more added importance when it's a home game, it's an Ivy League game, and it's a homecoming game. So, you know, we really picked a good time to play our best football of the year. And, you know, we finally got a little bit of momentum, we got a little bit of confidence, and, you know, I was really happy for the kids because, you know, we've worked hard the last 3 weeks, and we haven't had really that much to show for it. And so, you know, just trying to get them to stay the course, to continue to compete, to work hard, to believe in each other, trust each other, and eventually we'll work our way out of it. And, you know, I think we picked a pretty good week to do it. So really happy for our kids and really happy for the program, and the timing couldn't have been better. And, again, we'll use this hopefully as a springboard to just keep pushing it forward and improving. And, you know, we recognize we're on a short week on the road against a really talented Dartmouth team, so we're not going to be able to enjoy it too long, but certainly want to take time to enjoy what we've accomplished, and we'll worry about Dartmouth starting tomorrow. You know, if I knew, I would have done it 2 weeks ago. So, you know, I think a little bit has to do with, you know, we've had a lot of moving parts in the O-line. It was just trying to get those guys really to gel and play fast and really relax a little bit. You know, I think we've done a better job this week of incorporating a quarterback run game, which has been somewhat non-existent, and I think that kind of caught him a little bit off guard. So, you know, whether it was the keeper off the read or it was quarterback draw or quarterback power, but it was enough of a quarterback run game, you know, I think, to really keep those, you know, edge pressure guys from really trying to collapse the pocket on the pass play. So I think it was a combination of a lot of things. And then, you know, when you're able to run the ball effectively, it sets up play action. You're able to run the ball effectively. You stay somewhat on schedule, so we didn't have a tremendous amount of third and tens and third and nines and third and twelves. And so, you know, that kind of helps the momentum as well. And, you know, you add it all together, you kind of have a performance that you've been hoping for, and it finally came to fruition. Yeah, I mean, to us, it came, you know, he's an elite back. He's a guy that, you know, is by far the leading rusher in the league, both in terms of yards per game and probably even rushing average. And so he was the main guy that we were trying to say that offense starts and ends with him. And if they can run the ball effectively, it sets up a lot of play action. It sets up vertical shots. It sets up, you know, a lot of time of possession issues. And so our kids, starting with the kids up front and even second and third level, did a really nice job of setting the edge, not really letting them get outside, gang tackling them, and kind of negated any of those really big explosive plays, which, you know, he's kind of built a career on. Yeah, I mean, again, we know Josh is a little bit banged up, so I'm not going to divulge exactly what it is, but he's a little bit banged up. And we have confidence in both guys, and so it was a great week to say, hey, let's see if we can get them both healthy. You know, Ty's been playing great. We've got a lot of confidence in him. So, you know, he deserved the play. And, you know, again, I thought he gave us a dimension, especially in the run game, that we sorely had needed, and it allowed us to kind of move the chains, make some explosive run plays, which we really haven't done. And it just allowed us to keep the ball, utilize time of possession, and then score points. So it was good, and they played great. So, yeah, I mean, you know, we haven't been far off. I know the numbers have not been great, so trust, we look at the same thing. But when you're really watching on film, it's been like one guy kind of misses assignment, and that's kind of stopped the play. And I think today, without really looking at a film, I think we really had the front line guys finally play in a little bit of cohesion, play with a little bit of confidence. And so we were hitting targets correctly. Guys weren't slipping off as fast. We were able to get a couple cracks in there. And we have talented running backs. So we just have to really give them a chance to kind of get north and south and create some space. And I thought that finally happened today. So I know exactly what you're saying, but we had not really effectively had all five guys on the same page. We had four out of the five block the play well, but it took that one guy who kind of slipped off to make the tackle to put us in a second and nine, and that didn't happen today.